In this quick tip series for DaVinci Resolve, we are going to take a look at how to create a clean and simple bounce effect using a text plus node in DaVinci Resolve Fusion. This will be very useful for animated typography. So let's open a new project and get started. Alright, so if you are new here, be sure to hit the subscribe button and please like this video. Alright, so this is DaVinci Resolve 18.6 and all you have to do the project setting first. So click on the setting button in the corner and set the size of this project 1920 by 1080 which is a full HD resolution. You can also select your frame rate. So in this case, I'm using 60 frames per second for a smooth animation and then click on save. Now let's start by creating a new fusion composition which is very important. So just go to media pool, right click on that, click on new fusion composition. Let's call it fusion, duration make it 3 seconds long which is good enough for one text, frame rate 60 and click on create. Now drag and drop this fusion composition on the timeline just like that and then go to the fusion page. Here we have the media out node. Let's drag and drop to the side for now. We will use at the end of this animation. Now let's take a new text plus node. So this is the text icon. Drag and drop the text on the flow window. This is called flow window. And let's take a look. So drag and drop the text to the viewer to get a preview. We need only one viewer. So click on the single viewer. And after that, we have to type a text over here first. Just like that. Now let's select our favorite font style. So in this case, I'm using Bebas New Pro font style. You can select any font style that you like. Let's set the style regular. Let's increase the size of the text. I'm going to set the value 0.3, which is good. Now let's apply a modifier for the text animation. So just right click on this box, select this option follower, go to modifier. Here we have this setting tab. Just go to setting and here we have this position. Open the position property and this is the offset. So just right click on the offset, go to modify width, select this option XY path. Perfect. And here we have another modifier which is the follower offset XY path. And we have to animate the Y parameter for this animation. So first of all, we have to remove all the attached animation. So just right click on this X, click on remove XY path X1 and right click on this Y, click on this option, remove XY path. And as you can see, we don't have any animation. Now let's create fresh new keyframe. So just go to frame number 30, which is equal to half a second according to 60 frames per second. Right click on this Y and click on animate. You can simply click on the diamond button to create a keyframe and then just go to very first frame of this animation. Let's drag the text down just a little bit. So I'm going to set the value -0.5, hit enter. Perfect. So as you can see here, we have this type of animation. Perfect. Now just go to the follower one and here we have the opacity. So let's animate the opacity as well. So just go to frame number 30, right click on opacity, click on animate, go to very first frame of this animation. Let's set the opacity 0. Perfect. And now we have to add one more animation. So just go to transform. Here we have this spacing, which is the character spacing. So just right click on a spacing, click on animate. Go to very first frame of this animation. Let's set the spacing value 0.7. Perfect. Now we have to add one more animation. So just go to frame number 60, which is equal to 1 second. Right click on spacing, click on set key. And then just go to half a second forward in time, which is frame number 90. And then let's down the spacing value, set the spacing 0.95. Perfect. And then hold this position for half a second. So just go to 30 frame forward in time, frame number 120. Click on the diamond button to create a keyframe and then go to half a second forward in time, which is frame number 150 and let's set it default. Perfect. You can see here we have this type of animation. It is not looking good. So let's make it smoother. Just go to spline window. Hit F4 to full screen and here we have all the parameters. So we have to do one by one. Just check this character spacing first. Click on fit button and you can see all the keyframes. Simply, we have to select these two keyframes, hit S on the keyboard to smooth, or you can also click on this smooth button. Hold this handle and place this handle at the frame number 0 and create this type of smooth graph, which is looking nice. And we have to make a smooth curve for these keyframes. So select this keyframe, hit S, select these two, hit S. Perfect. Place the CDI over here, highlight this point, hold this handle and place it right over here. Highlight this one, hold this handle. You can see here, we have something like this. Just uncheck the character spacing, check the opacity, highlight these two keyframes, hit S, hold this handle and place it right over here. Now uncheck the opacity, check the offset. Again, we have to click on the fit button, highlight both the keyframes, hit S to smooth, hold this handle and create this type of graph. Perfect. Now we have smooth animation. Just close this spline window. Go to the timing and here we have the delay. So let's increase the delay value and set the value 5, I guess. And then you can take a look. Here we have this type of bouncy animation, which is looking absolutely perfect. Now we have to apply one more effect, which is not necessary, but if you have, then you can apply. Simply select the text node, hit Ctrl plus a space bar for search box and search for motion blur. So this is the motion blur node. Select that node, hit add button, drag and drop to the viewer. And now you can connect the motion blur output with this media out. And then you can go to the edit page and here we have nice and smooth bouncy animation. As you can see, it's looking nice. And after that, let me show you how you can create multiple text. Simply select the fusion composition, create a duplicate by holding alt on the keyboard. And now you can change the text. It is very simple. Place the CDI on any fusion composition. Go to the fusion page and here we have to type anything, whatever you like this. And then go to the edit page and here we have the first text and the second, and you can create multiple copy of that. You can also use this text on any background. It is very simple. Place this fusion composition on the second layer. Right click on this project window, go to import media. And then you can select any image and drag and drop the image on the timeline like this. And here we have the opacity. Let's set the opacity something around 15%. Perfect. Let's go to very first frame, turn on the loop button, hit Ctrl F to full screen and let's have a look. So that's a wrap for today's video. I hope you like it. For more such tips, subscribe to this channel, like this video and also comment below if you have any questions or thoughts. My name is Vikas Kumar and I will see you in the next one. Till then, bye-bye.